Well, thank you very much, Assemblymember Peoples-Stokes, and I'm so pleased to be here today, joined by so many of our presidents of the various campuses around the state, as well as the Chancellor and Trustee McCall. You know, I'm very proud of the fact that my 51st senatorial district is the home of more SUNY campuses than any other Senate district in the state. I have campuses at Cortland, Oneonta, Cobleskill. We have three community colleges, Herkimer, Tompkins-Cortland, as well as Columbia Green. And just outside my district, within a stone's throw of my district, are the campuses of Delhi, Morrisville, and the statutory colleges at Cornell. So I know firsthand that our SUNY schools are one of our state's greatest assets. Not only do they provide our future leaders with a quality, affordable education, but at the same time, our campuses partner with our local communities, as well as our state, in driving our local and statewide economy. And I was very impressed with the report that was issued just last week that indicated that our SUNY system it contributes nearly $20 billion to our state's economy on an annual basis, and that will be even greater in years to come. And very appropriately, there's been a renewed focus of late on our SUNY system. We've heard UB 2020, SUNY 2020. There have been summits on Buffalo, and just yesterday on Stony Brook. But this is, it seems to me, this is the opportune time to take action to benefit and enhance the entire SUNY system. You know, for years I've advocated for a predictable, rational tuition policy. It seems to me that students and parents alike should be able to plan for the cost of a college education. And the campuses faced with budget difficulties need a stable, predictable funding source. And I'm very pleased to be partnering with Assemblymember Crystal Peoples-Stokes in introducing legislation that would, in fact, create a predictable five-year tuition policy that reinvests all the tuition dollars back into this SUNY programs to benefit our students and our campuses. I believe tuition dollars should directly benefit students by going straight into the classrooms of our SUNY campuses. And with this legislation, no longer will students' hard-earned tuition dollars be swept into the state's general fund to fill a black hole of a budget deficit at the statewide level. It would go right into reinvesting these funds into students' education. So during these tough times, economic tough times, these modest tuition increases will ensure that SUNY remains a vital contributor to not only the future of our state from an educational point of view, but continue to be a contributor in a big way to our state's economy. So very, very important as we focus on the future of SUNY of our state that we take action to benefit the entire SUNY system and its students. And I believe that one of the best ways we can do that is through enacting a rational tuition policy for our state.